Hey there, this is Shivani and welcome to the channel Science with Shivani. Today, we are going to do 5 awesome experiments. So, without any further ado, let's get started. I have a pen and a balloon. Well, obviously. And I have a tray of pens. Now, let's see what happens. So here is the tray I used. Notice it's the pointed head above and the spacing is kept very uniform. So what is the reason behind all of these? Well, it is a game of force and pressure. As you can see, force is not the reason why balloon burst. The main reason is pressure. When we use a single pin, the pressure exerted on balloon is high. But when we use a uniform tray of pins, the pressure becomes very low. Hence, the balloon does not burst. For this experiment, I have colored water on a plate. The candle is attached on the plate. Let me light up the candle. Pause a moment. What do you think will happen next? Give yourself a little time and keep your answers ready. Now, let's see. Let us have a closer look. There are two things happening here. Candle flame going off and water level rising up. Let us try to understand the reason behind it. Well, combustion requires oxygen. Or in simple words, we can say any kind of fire requires oxygen to exist. So, flame went off due to the lack of oxygen. That was pretty obvious, right? But what about the rise in water level? Actually, the pressure inside the glass becomes lower than the pressure outside. Because of the difference in pressure, the water level rises up. But what is causing the difference in pressure? The burning of candle produces carbon dioxide and water vapor by consuming oxygen. Water vapor is much denser than oxygen. So, the pressure decreases and thus, water gets sucked up into the glass. For the next experiment, we will need milk, some colors and soap. So here is the closer look. You can see the colors are creating art by themselves. Actually, this can come out a lot better. Maybe the milk is being camera shy. Sorry people. Try doing this experiment by yourself. If you wish, you can reach out to me in Instagram and send me pictures of your version of this experiment. The link is given in the description box down below. I would like to take out a little time over here and appreciate this cute little scientist, a 5-year-old kid trying out my experiment from the previous video. Also, to the mother of the kid, thank you very much for putting in the effort and for sharing it with me. If you want to check out the video, you can check it out from here. In that video, I had also asked a question. Can we boil water without heating it? The answer is yes, we can. And we are gonna do it now. Here I have a syringe. 1/3 of it is filled with water. We should make sure there's no air bubble left in it. Now let's see. You just witnessed water being boiled without heat. Not satisfied? Let's do it again. The air bubble should be removed. And here we go. Was the water really boiling or was there any trick? It is real and it is all science. Boiling of any liquid depends on two factors, temperature and pressure. When we increase the pressure, the boiling point of a liquid increases. But when we decrease the pressure, the boiling point decreases. In our case, we decreased the pressure so much that the boiling point came out to room temperature. Have you noticed that water boils at lower temperature and places of high altitude? Well, now you know the reasons as well. Here, I have some baking soda and vinegar. Let me pour the vinegar into the bottle. And let us put some baking soda into a balloon. Now, let's see. You can see the balloon is getting filled with some gas. So what is happening here? Well, vinegar is an acid and baking soda is a base. When they mix, they react to neutralize each other. And by this reaction, carbon dioxide and salt is formed. So the gas inside the balloon is carbon dioxide. But how to be sure about this? Here I have a candle flame. Let me take out the balloon. Let me pour the gas into this glass. Watch. Yes, carbon dioxide extinguishes fire. I hope you enjoyed the experiment. If you enjoyed it, please share it with people whom you think will enjoy science. And also please put in a little effort to show it to the kids around you. Maybe your nephew, your niece, your baby cousin, or maybe even your kid. Please show this to them. Let them develop a scientific temper. And let us build a science community. Share, comment, subscribe. Bye-bye.